Hello, this is Dr. Bansi Sausani, and my topic is diagnostic efficacy of MRI in cerebellopontine angle lesion. Now, what is a CP angle? It is a cistern of subarachnoid space which containing cranial nerves and vessels within the CSF. CP angle is bounded anteriorly by the bones, posterior by the anterior aspect of the cerebellum, and the petrous temporal bone covered by the dura mater. It is centered by internal auditory canal, extend caudally from the 5th cranial nerve to the 9th, 10th, and 11th cranial nerve complexes. Three most common lesions of CP angles are schwannoma, meningioma, and the epidermoid cyst, in which the schwannoma is account for 70 to 80% most common tumor of CP angle. The tumor of CP angle may be arising from the various anatomical structures, primarily originating from the internal auditory meatus, pontocerebellar cistern, lateral recess of fourth ventricle, brainstem, cerebellar nervous tissue. And the clinical symptoms of all the CP angle tumors are mainly headache, vomiting, vertigo. So we cannot differentiate the pathology or extent of CP angle by this. So we need some neurological imaging modality to assess the extent and the type of lesion allow for the proper treatment. So MRI is considered as a superior in differentiating the different types of CPA masses. So the typical characteristic features, more specific features like ice cream cone appearance in case of schwannoma, adjacent hyperostosis, dural tail sign in case of meningioma, enlargement of internal auditory canal, this helps in limiting the differentiation. Recent reports of MRI, normal anatomy of lesions of the CP angle and internal auditory canal is most important. Why MRI? Because of absence of beam hardening artifact, multiplanar imaging capability, and greater intrinsic soft tissue contrast have a significant advantages of MRI in compared to the CT. The aim of my study is to evaluate the current role of MRI in the diagnosis of CPA angle lesions, assess the effectiveness and accuracy of the MRI in case of CPA angle lesions, and evaluate the role of MRI and the contrast enhanced MRI as imaging modality in the diagnosis of CPA angle lesions. In my study, I carried 25 patients into a period of one and a half year. I include the patients who are willing to participate in the study with the CPA angle lesion detected on contrast MRI in all age group. Patients who are not willing to participate are excluded from the study with having a history of claustrophobia and the contraindications to MRI. MRI performed with the 1.5 Tesla MR Philips Achiva using a dedicated head coil. Study is carried out with the patient in lying down supine position. We use a T1, T2 sequences, flare sequences, post-contrast images, diffusion weighted, and FFE. Contrast imaging is performed by using a gadolinium DTPA contrast agent. Now, the distribution of patients according to the age. So most common age group involved is 45 to 55 year of age. Young adults like 15 to 35 years of age are less commonly involved. Distribution of patient according to sex. The female are most predominant than the male. Distribution according to the clinical symptoms. Out of 25, 16 patients shows a headache. So headache is the most common clinical symptoms, followed by vomiting. Distribution of patient according to the type of lesion. So as I say, the schwannoma is the most commonest type of lesion of CP angle. So out of 25, 11 patients shows a schwannoma, while arachnoid cyst and paraganglioma is very less common. In my study, the commonest lesion found is schwannoma in 44% cases. Most common age group involved is 45 to 55 years with woman predominance. Most common symptom is headache followed by vomiting. The first pathology is meningioma. Meningioma is the benign lesion arising from the meninges. Okay, so it is on the flare image. As you can see in A image, there is a well-defined, broad-based, hyperintense lesion in left CP angle. On B image, you can see it obliterates the course of 7th and 8th nerve. On post-contrast image, there is a homogeneous post-contrast enhancement and dural tail sign, which is the pathognomic for meningioma. Arachnoid cyst. Arachnoid cyst is the benign cystic lesion present in the subarachnoid space, which contain a CSF. So it follows a CSF signal in all the sequences. So on T1, it is hyperintense. T2 is hyperintense. On flare, there is a suppress completely on the flare images, and there is a no diffusion restriction. Epidermoid cyst. It is a very rare congenital cystic lesion It shows a CSF intensity in both T1 and T2, which flare image shows a heterogeneously hyperintense lesion with no post-contrast enhancement, and there is a diffusion restriction. This point is very helpful to differentiating between the arachnoid cyst and epidermoid cyst. There is a diffusion restriction is seen in epidermoid cyst. Now, schwannoma is the most commonest lesion of CP angle, and it is a nerve cyst tumor which is arising from the cranial nerves. So on T1 images, as you can see in A image, there is a hypointense lesion. On T2 and flare, there is a heterogeneously hyperintense lesion with post-contrast heterogeneous enhancement. And it is extending to the internal auditory canal, which gives it an ice cream cone appearance. This is a pathognomic feature for the schwannoma. Now, glomus jugulare or paraganglioma, it is mainly seen in the jugular fossa. Okay, so it shows a heterogeneously hypointense on T2, heterogeneously hyperintense on heterogeneously hypo on T1, heterogeneously hyperintense on T2, and on GRE there is an area of blooming of microhemorrhages and post contrast intensive enhancement. Salt and pepper appearance is the pathognomic for the paraganglioma. So these are the characteristic and suggestive feature of CP angle lesions to differentiate the various type of CP angle lesions. Like in schwannoma, there is an ice cream cone appearance. In meningioma, there is a dural tail sign. We can differentiate epidermoid cyst and arachnoid cyst by the diffusion weighted images, as diffusion restriction in epidermoid and there is no diffusion restriction in arachnoid. And paraganglioma, there is a salt and pepper appearance, which is a pathognomic feature for the paraganglioma. Yeah, there is a heterogeneously hypointense on T1 and heterogeneously hyperintense. It gives a salt and pepper appearance. So the MRI is very useful method to improve the sensitivity of CP angle lesion detection. And it is very gold standard method to differentiating the lesion by its site of origin, its shape, its signal intensity, behavior after the injection of contrast media. So in some cases, a complementary MRI technique like diffusion, as I say that epidermoid and arachnoid differentiated only by diffusion weighted images. So diffusion weighted images is complementary, useful in some lesions. MRI has excellent diagnostic accuracy and sensitivity and specificity in CP angle lesions diagnosis, and also extent and involvement of adjacent structures for the preoperative planning. So MRI is the best. Contrast MRI is the modality of choice in case of CP angle tumors and differentiating the CP angle tumors. Thank you so much. And special thanks to my co-author. Thank you so much.